laughing and running, hating, skipping and jumping. Hi everyone, welcome to class. Grab yourself a chair and we'll get started in just a minute. Find yourself comfortably seated on the chair, knees above your ankles, allow your feet to rest on the floor, spread your toes a little bit, maybe spread your fingers a little bit as well, and maybe stretch your face a little bit, just to wake us up, toes and fingers and face. Good job. Okay. And just releasing if there's any tension in your neck. We'll do some breathing. Bring one hand and place it on your abdomen, on your tummy, and the other one place it on top. And if you want, you can close your eyes with me or you can keep them open. And we're going to breathe in and out three times. Breathing in. Out, breathing in and out, last one, breathing in and out. With breathing or any of the movements that we do in this class, you move more or less than you want to, subject to feeling good. You want to feel comfortable, relaxed, releasing some tension and having some creative expression while we dance together. You might be noticing as you just breathe naturally now that your hands are moving a little bit with the breath, with your tummy expanding and contracting. We're just going to explore the tummy by making a circle with our hands. Imagine that your tummy is like a ball or something, and you're gently navigating the curves or the muscles, the firmness and the softness of your tummy. Stirring a pot, if you would. Good. And you'll notice as you do this that your elbows are also moving. It's a coordinated movement. My elbows are bending. And as I extend down, they release a little bit. And also my shoulders are moving. So allow yourself to just be aware of that. And then we're going to make the circle a bit bigger. So we're going to go down one leg. Across to the other knee and up. Back across the tummy, down the leg, to the other knee and back. And you can go really slowly or you can play with going a bit faster. But you want to keep the contact with the body, maintain that contact with your body. Come up higher, across the chest and down. And try in the other direction. Again, it can be very small. Good work. Now we're going to slowly take our hands off our tummy and continue with the circle. Continuing the circle. Good. Now if you bring your hands apart and just imagine a thread that's holding these fingers together. It could be a few of your fingers or just the one, but it's like there's a thread, and as you go around there's a thread that goes all the way along your arm, across your chest, and continues back around your other arm and connects. So there's like a silk thread connecting you. And we'll keep doing the circles. So we've been doing circles that we can see like that. Now try a circle that goes away from you. Away from you like this. If you're comfortable to stand up, you're welcome to stand up while we do this, but it can be done very effectively while sitting down. So now try different directions. One direction, the other direction. One direction, the other direction. Close and far. Good. Great. Now with your interlace, we're going to turn one of your hands so the palm is facing out, and we're going to clasp the fingers together. What this does is rotates this shoulder a little bit, so just make sure it's comfortable for you. And again, we're going to move. Just do as much as is comfortable. You don't have to go as fast or as far as I do. But if you're comfortable, you can explore with your range. So this shoulder's slightly rotated because of the shape we're making. Good. Marvellous. I'm getting a bit of a stretch whilst I do this, which is nice. And now I'm going to swap the interlace. So my hands will come out, I'm going to swap, and then bring them together. And then we'll do the same. Oh. Notice that I'm getting a stretch through my tummy and my back and my shoulders quite a lot. And now we're going to come back to the thread and the silk thread. And I'm just going to get you to allow a bit of space, but still imagine the thread. And then as we move, I might do this standing up. I'll just bring my chair to the side. But it's always handy to have for stability, your chair. You can still do this seated, it's fine. So just that little bit of space. So now I'm going to work with both hands going in a similar direction each time. It's almost like you're placing something somewhere. Placing something down, little bend in the knees. Placing something over there. Placing something up high. Just as in range that is comfortable for you. Good work. Great. So we're placing. Good. Allowing that sense of the silk around our arms and our chest. And now, you place your imaginary object in one spot. And then you follow the thread with the other hand to another spot. And then you bring that to that spot. And then down or up to another spot. Along and across to another spot. Down. And then we bring them together. So this is just in whatever way you want. So they come apart and they come together. They go together, and they come back, and then apart, apart, and together. Maintaining that sense of that, like there's silk, like silk flowing, a silk thread. And that sense sort of a softness of placing something in a spot, and then coming back. Placing something and coming back. Placing two things. So you're playing between placing one thing and placing two things. Placing one thing and placing two things. Good. One thing. I'll let you hear the music a little bit. It's rather pretty music. We'll do it together. Play with speed. If you like to go fast, you can. Or range. of us it might be more in the wrists. And for others, the whole shoulders and the whole body might play a part. Up high and down low. Working our arms quite strongly, and we're going to have a bit of a rest with the chair. We'll focus a little bit more on our legs. So come into a comfortable standing position and give yourself, let your arms just relax on the chair, and we're going to do some heel raises or calf raises as they're known. And we're going to do both at the same time. So just very gently, you want to lift your heels up off the ground. To do that, you bring your weight forward a little bit, depending on the, your strength. But the weight comes forward onto the balls of the feet, and you raise up. And only go as far as is comfortable. Yeah, for some people this is quite a strong weight transfer. Okay. So we go up. And down, up, and down. When you come down, if you want to try, you can lift your toes off the ground just a little bit, just to get a little bit more things flowing down in the feet, which often can get still and not as bendy as they can be. So as you come back on the heels, toes come up, up on the heels, down. Toes. Good. We're just going to do two more after this one. Up. In your own time though, I'm encouraging down with the timing, but you do your own timing. Up. Down. Okay. So now, I think you can still be facing your chair, but I'm going to face you just for the purposes of this exercise. So you're standing with split weight between both legs. I do want you to just bring a bit of weight, or bring your weight to the side closest to the chair. And that can feel like a lot for some people, so just be mindful. And if you can, you lift that heel off the ground, so you come to your, maybe your toe. I want you to think about this leg like a tree. So there's roots going deep down into the ground. There's that real sense of being grounded. But also those roots are drinking water and nutrients, and there's also a sense of a rebound or a bounce or an upward energy. All your muscles wrapping. So you've got, once you've got weight, but also energy. And if you need to, it's probably a good idea for everyone, have a little bit of a bent knee. You don't have to lock your knee, because that can block energy, which we don't want to do. We want to be relaxed and soft and strong as we can be, as strong as we can be on any given day. So always come back to 2 feet if this gets too strong. So we're imagining that this leg is the tree, and want to imagine that this leg is the leaves. And there's a bit of a breeze. So just in your own exploration, allow this leg to be like the leaves. Maybe blowing in the breeze. Now you can keep your toe or toes on the ground, or even your foot, if that feels comfortable. They're blowing, so you've got your strong trunk that still moves. When you see the big strong trees, their trunks, they still sometimes move a bit. If you're comfortable, you might find that you can lift your knee. This is totally optional. All of this is optional. Don't feel that you need to do anything. You may be here your leaves might be your arm. That is great, actually. Or it can be a leg, or it could be a combination of both. So you might be facing this way, got your trunk, and you're just exploring what range do you have? What range of movement is comfortable? Yeah. If you feel very comfortable, you might find a larger range of movement. Who knows? I'm getting a bit of a sore, oh, not sore, tired leg, so I'm going to swap. Probably a good time to swap anyway. So we have split weight. Bring your weight into your left leg. Just gently there. Good work. Again, imagining you've come onto your toe, imagining the roots deep, deep down, and also a sense of energy coming up through your leg. And there you are. And then you're finding where you can be soft. You've got a strong leg working, a working leg, but where can there be softness? Where can your leaves, your expressive leaves? Or is it your expressive lower limbs, your expressive legs? Find some exploration of movement and range and research that is comfortable for you. Not trying to look like anything, it's the feeling that I'm hoping to share with you. A feeling of having one, a strong base, but then also space to move, capacity to feel that. And now we're going to gently come back to parallel. You might choose to sit down again. And I think we're just going to, like we did last week, just work with these qualities that we've discussed today. So the silk along the arms and through the body. So whatever that looks like or feels like for you, you know. And playing with the two and the separated. And the two placing down and the separated. And then also just experimenting with weight transfer and some movement. I'm just going to do that for a little bit. Move this over. Try and do it without too much talking. So maybe there's a quality of wind, a sense of winds passing. It is a time when we are feeling lots of turmoil, sometimes like we're stuck in the wind or blowing in the wind. So this is an opportunity to explore that. Find where is our strength when we're in the wind. And when can we release? dancing. Thank you for coming to class today.